Hi guys, this is Iman Sheikhansari. In this video, I will cover the topic of how to install Ladybug tools and the new release of Ladybug tools version 1. As you might know, Ladybug tools is a Grasshopper plugin, and Grasshopper itself is a plugin for rhinoceros. What Ladybug tools, as I scroll down their official website, is that it connects Rhino as a 3D CAD software and Grasshopper as a computational design platform to different environmental design toolkit like Energy Plus, Daysim, Radiance, OpenFoam, and lots of toolkit that is out there, and you could use it comprehensively and effectively. So, in order to work with Ladybug tools, you should first have rhinoceros. And for having rhinoceros, you could go to their official website, rhinoceros3d.com, click on download, open it in a new tab, and you could have easily Rhino 6 for Windows for about 90 days as an evaluation. But I will work mostly on the beta version of Rhino for Rhino 7, so in future, anybody who sees this video could use it. Actually, I've installed the Rhino, and so if I wanted to reinstall it, I face this message that your Rhino is installed. That's easy procedure. You go through and have the rhinoceros. After installing rhinoceros and open it, I open the version 6 and show it. You have a green button that says launch Grasshopper. This is the official window of rhinoceros 6. As you see, it's like different CAD software. It has a ribbon menu to access the command and the sidebar menu. We will go and launch Grasshopper. As you see, Grasshopper is a built-in plugin, and after you install it, you face this canvas, and here you could have in this ribbon different toolkit that you need or you want installed. So actually, the next step is to download Ladybug tools. But to install Ladybug tools, we should go to foodforrhino.com, which is a platform for downloading Grasshopper and Rhino plugins. After you log in, you see under the tab of Grasshopper tab, Ladybug tools. I open the Ladybug tools tab. Here you see different description for what is Ladybug tools, who develop it, and how it works. And if you click on a download button here, you will be redirected to different version of it. In this video, we will work on Ladybug tools 102, which is released on October 6, yesterday. If I wanted to download it, I should first log in. If you click on login, you will be directed to this web page. And if you already have an account, you could write it and log in. If not, you should register it. For the sake of security, I will pause the video and put my information in. After I log in, as you see my account, there is a download button, and when you click it, the download is available for you. It's easy. You click on download and it will be redirected you to download the file. After I download it, there is a zip file on my desktop, and I open it, and you see it's Ladybug Tools 102. So I extract it on my desktop, and here you see. Installation is very, very easy. As you open up the folder, you will face a Grasshopper definition and installation instruction. If I open it, the installation instruction, it will be redirected you to an installation instruction that is on GitHub, and I will post the link. And let's open it and see how we could install it. I copy it and paste it on my browser. So here is the GitHub site that said how we could install it on Windows installation. If you open it, it has the Mac installation and different tool. I open the Windows installation, and as you see, it redirected you to open the installer GH file and click the toggle to true, and you have Ladybug tools. So we follow these steps. And here we go. I open up my Rhino beta version, so you see there is no difference between Rhino 6 and the new Rhino 7. Here we go. I now has the installer file, and uninstall. This is a simple drag and drop procedure. Here's the first step. It says follow this instruction. You double click on a toggle false and it will be automatically be true, and you have the Ladybug installation first step completed. So as you see, when the toggle turns into true, it automatically directs you and said what are the next step and you should do. As it's stated here, we should double click on the false toggle here and turn this to true like the above component. As you see, when the toggle is turned into true, it shows me different messages here in this panel that said all the things is ready to go and we could start using it. But there's always a but. As you see here, we should close Rhino and go to the user I Ladybugtools or your user and open and run their Python passbat file. So I close my Rhino, the beta version. Here it said there's a changes in your Grasshopper file. Do you want to save it? Okay, we close it because we don't want to save it. And also I have Rhino 6 open, which I should close it. So I close my Rhino 6 and go to the direction which is mentioned before, C user I and Ladybug. So I'm here at the direction which is said, and you could access it to C user, your username and Ladybug tools. And I open the set Python pass, and here you see a CMD command window that is open, and you press any key and that's it. You have your Ladybug tools installed. So I've just reopened my rhinoceros beta version. I click on Grasshopper and wait to see the Grasshopper windows. And now as you see on the top, we have HB Radiance, which is Honeybee for Radiance Engine. We have Honeybee itself. We have Ladybug. And we have Honeybee Energy, and also we have Dragonfly, which is in the previous version, was not a plugin that you should install. To be sure that you have installed your version correctly, you could go to the zero tab called import and put up one of the components out of a canvas. I put Ladybug download layer file and I think it's good to go. It said it need a WebFire URL. So in order to have the WebFire URL, I need to open Ladybug EPW map. And as you see here, it needs a Boolean toggle. So I type toggle and click on true. And you see a world map opens, so I zoom into Iran and select, for example, Tehran Mehrabad Airport and copy the link to clipboard, minimize it, go back here. I go to prom and drag and drop a panel into canvas, double click on canvas and paste the copied link and drag the wire and connect it to weather file URL. I think everything is should good to be good, but unfortunately the verify for Tehran Mehrabad is not available. So let's go to more popular cities, like I don't know, let's type London. And here I click on the red button here for London, copy link to clipboard, and we'll do the same. Here we go. Oh, there's very important thing. You shouldn't put enter. I click on backspace and click on canvas. That's very important to procedure about the panel and how it works. And you see my Grasshopper window suddenly goes down. Don't worry, it's not a big deal. You should click on Grasshopper again. Sometimes it happens. And here we go, we have the EPW file, and in the next video we will go through how to use EPW files effectively. Hope you enjoyed this video and you have successfully Ladybug tools on your computer installed. Have a great day, see you in the next video.